Hi, this is Abdur Sigdur, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a project from the C# programming language, and how to read data from a file and storing them in an array, and then you can display it in a list box. So let's start. Create a new project. Excuse me. So the project will be Windows Form App. Next. So you're creating it in the user directory. All right, so here it is. The form shows up and control there. So what we need to do, we need to create a list box. So you create a list box in terms of our design goes. Get a bigger list box. And we create a button. Just show elements. That's it. Input button called show elements, and we may have another button to close this form. Let's say another button when exiting the form. Exit there, and that's it. So let's start writing code. So for exit, you put this dot close parenthesis semicolon. That's all close the form. Redesign and show the elements. Now I'm going to declare an array, okay, and integer array, of course. And name of the array, we can say numbers array, and then we assign a value to that. Assign some values, and size, we give them a size, okay. What kind of array we want a int array, okay, so new, and then you have to say int. And then I put the size of the array. So let's say we have five elements in the array. So this array can hold five elements, numbers array. Now we declare an integer counter, index equal to 0, index. So we can add counter variable into the index equal to 0. Now we're gonna open a file, actually read. So we're gonna use this system.io. We need to have this using system.io. Then you can use read on stream writer to read and write information to a file. So you can use stream reader input file equal to file dot open text, because you're going to read the existing file, open text, and name of the file, so you can put numbers. .txt. That file is just read it from the previous video. I'm going to use that file to read it and put it in the array and then write to a list box. That's our goal. So we use a while loop. Then I use this index equal to 0, index less than the length. So we already have declared this index. Use the condition. If while index less than numbers array, the size of that, but length, then and we put another condition, another logical and not end of while, end of string. Not end of a stream, input file dot and out end of stream, not exception, end of stream, and not end of stream, then do this. Numbers array. And put the index there. Index equal and it parse it. So the parse. So int parse the input file dot read line. Input file dot read line. So reading the line and parsing it and to the integer and so read line should have access. That's it. So we do this and then we index. We read the next line until the end of the file. So that will be that. We can close the input file. Input file. Dot close. Now you're going to use a for each loop to read the array and write it to the list box. So that's our goal. So for is structured as like this, int value in numbers array. In the numbers array, we read all these numbers and put it right on the output file. No, not output file, the list box. So you put the list box 1, that's the name of the box, box 1, dot text. So you know we have a list box, so we need to add item to list box. So item dot add and value reading from the array. So you wrote that and that will write the elements of the array to the file. We have some 36. Oh, here. Where is this semicolon? So you're reading that and put it in the list box, and that's it. That should work. So let's run this program. Show it's not working because the file we're trying to read is not there. So what do you need to do? We need to go back and restart this program. So I need to go back and copy that file from that that directory here, S1. We copy it. Let's copy that and put it on the other folder. Debug, yeah, bin, go back, yes, here. Windows format 9, bin directory, debug, and 9, go back. So we put it here. So now the numbers files are there, so this should be able to read it from there. So let's run this program again. Program here, run it. Now you can see that. So it's reading the file and put it on the list box. So let's exit the program, change the design a little bit, go to the design, we can put a label here and name it. Let's give a name there. Elements first. There. Have it there. Yeah. And now, finally, we can run the program and show that our elements there and exit. So let's go back to the code and try to understand it. So what do we have done here? We declare an integer, which integer array named numbers array, which can hold 5 elements. And then we declared an index, integer index, because we're going to use that for while loop. And we added using system.io on here, because we need to use this system reader to read it. So system reader input file into file.open text. So you're opening the text file number.txt, and then we are using while loop to read the file until the end of the file and put it on this array. So assigning the value, and then why you use parse? Because when you read a line from a text box from a text file, it comes as a string. So in order to put it back to the array, this array is an integer array, so you have to parse it to integer. So they use int parse. And then we increment it because we're gonna read next line and then put it on the array, next line until the end of the file. And then we close the file, and then use a for each loop. We use a for each loop to read the array and adding each item to the list box. So that's what we're exactly doing. Reading the numbers array element and then put it in a list box. So list box 1.item.add and value, and it works perfectly fine. So hope this will help you to understand how to read an element from an array and